Branch accounts. Introduction. Hello friends. In this lesson, we are going to discuss the branch accounting and the various methods followed for recording accounting entries. Before that, we will briefly discuss the background and definition of branch. In the modern days, the competition in various fields is becoming cutthroat day by day. As a strategy to face competition is to reach maximum number of customers as much as possible. One of the ways to achieve this is to open branches at various places to cater to the needs of maximum number of customers. It should be remembered that through opening as many branches as possible has become inevitable. It is of paramount importance to look after the accounting aspect of the branches thus open. It is necessary to record the various transactions which are taking place between the branch and the head office. Thus, in this lesson, we are going to discuss the accounting methods used to record the transactions taking place between branch and head office. We will start with the definition of branch as given in the Companies Act 2013. A branch office is any establishment described as a branch by the company. Any establishment carrying on either the same or substantially the same activity as that carried on by the head office of the company, any establishment engaged in any production, processing or manufacturing, but does not include any establishment specified in the central government's order. Number 3, classification of branches. There are various types of branches. Accounting systems to a great extent depend upon the type of the branch. Now we will see the classification of branches. A. Inland branches. Inland branches are the branches open in the country. Thus, a company may have head office in Mumbai and have branches at various places in India such as Pune, Ahmednagar, Ahmedabad, etc. The inland branches are further divided into two categories. Number 1, dependent branches. These are the branches in respect of which the whole of the accounting records are kept at the head office only. The branch do not maintain the books of accounts. Number 2, independent branches. These branches maintain independent accounting records. B. Foreign branches. These are the branches which are located in a foreign country. For example, in a country other than in which the company is incorporated and registered. Number 4, methods of accounting. The accounting methods used in the case of branch are explained now. Number 1, debtors method. Number 2, stock and debtors method. Number 3, final accounts methods. These methods are now discussed. Number 1, debtors method. Under this system, the head office opens one branch account to record various transactions with the branch. Branch account is maintained in the form of debtors account. In the books of the head office, branch account is debited with all the goods supplied and all the expenses made by head office and credited with all remittances and returns. Similar to customers account, therefore, the system can be called debtor system or one account system. The excess of the credit over its debit represents a profit or vice versa and is transferred to general profit and loss account of head office. Branch account is prepared in the books of head office and it is a nominal account. From accounting point of view, there are further three types of accounting under debtor system. A. Branches receive goods from head office at cost price and authorized to sell them for cash only. B. Branches receive goods from head office at cost price and are authorized to sell them for cash and credit. C. Branches receive goods from head office at cost plus certain percentage of profit. Now we will see the illustration of this method. Illustration. Prepare a branch account in the books of head office from these particulars for the year ended 31st March 2016. On the assumption that head office sells goods at cost price plus 25%. Particulars are given for that. If you see on the debit side, particulars and amount are given on one side, and again on the other side, particulars and amounts are given. Opening stock at invoice price 12,400 rupees. Opening debtors 5,000 rupees. Petty cash opening 1,000. Goods sent to branch at invoice price 40,000 rupees. Goods sent to head office 5,000 rupees. Cash sales rupees 12,000. Cash received from debtors 30,000. Bad debts rupees 2,000. Allowances to customers rupees 1,000. Return inwards 1,000. Charges sent to bank. Rates and taxes 3,000. Salaries 8,000. Miscellaneous expenses 1,000. Closing stock at invoice price 15,000. Closing debtors 4,000 and closing petty cash 1,000. We will now proceed to prepare the branch account in the books of head office as per debtors system. Now see the illustration. In the books of the head office, we have opened branch account. We will take up the debit side first and then go to the credit side. To balance brought down is the first entry. In that we have taken stock 12,400 rupees, debtors 5,000 rupees and petty cash is 1,000, and the total amount that is taken in the outer column is 18,400 rupees. To goods sent to branch account 40,000 rupees, to bank account rates and taxes are 3,000, salaries are 8,000 and miscellaneous expenses are 1,000. The total of all these expenses come to 12,000 rupees taken in the outer column. To goods sent to branch account, this is the loading on the goods which are written. Amount is taken as rupees 1,000. To stock reserve, that is loading on the closing stock. Amount is taken as rupees 3,000. And then to general profit and loss account, which is actually difference between the credit side total and the debit side total, and that amount is taken as the 3,000 rupees. If you see the credit side, we have got by stock reserve, which is loading on the opening stock, amount is taken as 2,500 rupees. Then there is an entry for by bank account. Under that, entry is for cash sales 12,000 rupees, cash received from debtors 30,000 rupees. Total amount taken in the outer column is 42,000 rupees. Then the entry is by goods sent to branch. This is for return of goods to head office. Amount is 5,000. By goods sent to branch account is the next entry. This is the loading on the goods sent. Amount is taken as 8,000. And finally, we have taken the closing balances at the end of the year. And the closing balances at the end of the year represent stock 15,000, debtors 4,000 and petty cash that is taken as 1,000. The total amount taken is rupees 20,000 and a total on both the sides 77,500 rupees. Now going to the asterisk marks that we have done in the case of the accounts. The first asterisk marks explains the goods are sent at invoice price, which is cost price plus 25%. Thus, the amount of this entry is rupees 40,000, which is the invoice price. Similarly, next explanation, the loading on goods sent by the return by the branch now is calculated. Invoice price of goods returned by branch is rupees 5,000. The loading is rupees 5,000 into 1/5, that is rupees 1,000. Explanation 3, loading on closing stock. Invoice price of closing stock is rupees 15,000. Loading rupees 15,000 into 1/5, that is rupees 3,000. Explanation 4, loading on opening stock. Invoice price of opening stock is rupees 12,500 and loading is rupees 12,500 into 1/5, that is rupees 2,500. Explanation number 5, loading on goods sent to branch. Invoice price of goods sent is rupees 40,000 and the loading rupees 40,000 into 1/5, that is rupees 8,000. Now, we will discuss the second method of keeping accounts, that is stock and debtor system. Stock and debtor system, where there are large number of transactions, this method is particularly maintained by the head office to make efficient control over the branches. Under this method, accounts to be open are branch stock account into bracket at invoice price, branch debtors account, branch adjustment account in the bracket for recording loading on goods and for ascertaining gross profit, D, branch profit and loss account for ascertaining branch net profit, E, goods sent to branch. In addition to the accounts, there are certain accounts which may also be open. A, branch expenses account, B, branch cash account, C, branch cash account, D, abnormal loss / lost in transit account. In addition to the accounts, there are certain accounts which may also be open, namely A, branch expenses account, B, branch cash account, C, abnormal loss / lost in transit account. Under this method, the most important account is the branch adjustment account, which helps to ascertain gross profit. It takes only the loading on opening stock, closing stock, goods sent to branch, goods returned by branch, any abnormal loss, surplus of stock, etc. Apparent profit and apparent loss. An unusual increase or decrease in the value of stock arises in branch stock account due to inaccurate prediction of the expected selling price of the goods which are invoiced by the head office. Usually, head office sends goods after charging a certain percentage of profit, that is at invoice price. However, it may happen that the said goods are sold either at a price which is higher than the invoice price or lower than the invoice price rather than the price fixed by the head office. Thus, the branch stock account may show either surplus of stock, which is known as apparent profit, or a shortage of stock, which is known as apparent loss. The apparent profit or apparent loss is recorded through an entry. For apparent profit, branch stock account debited to apparent profit account, apparent profit account debited to branch stock adjustment account. For apparent loss, the entries will be reversed. The accounts to be opened along with their objective under stock and debtors system. Number 1, branch stock account to ascertain gross profit or gross loss. Branch profit and loss account to ascertain net profit. Branch debtors account to record receivables / credit sales, etc. Branch expenses account to record expenses incurred at branch. Number 5, branch cash account to control branch cash position / remittances. Number 6, branch adjustment account to reverse loading, that is unrealized profits if any. 7, goods sent to branch to record goods sent / return. Number 8, branch assets account to record assets at branch if any. Now, we will see the illustration of this method. Illustration. M Stores Limited Delhi has its branches at Lucknow and Chennai. It charges goods to its branch at cost plus 25%. Information available of the transactions of the Lucknow branch for the year ended 31st March 2016. We have two columns, particulars and amount. Balance as on 1st April 2015, stock at invoice price rupees 30,000, debtors rupees 10,000, petty cash rupees 50. Transactions during the year at Lucknow branch. Goods sent to Lucknow branch into bracket invoice price rupees 3,25,000. Goods returned to head office into bracket invoice price 10,000. Cash sales rupees 1 lakh. Credit sales rupees 1,75,000. Goods pilfered into bracket at invoice price rupees 2,000. Goods lost by fire into bracket at invoice price rupees 5,000. Insurance company paid to head office for loss by fire rupees 3,000. Cash sent for petty expenses 34,000. Bad debts at branch 500. Goods transferred to Chennai branch under head office advice 15,000. Insurance charges paid by head office 500. Goods returned by debtors rupees 500. Balances as on 31st March 2016, petty cash 230, debtors 14,000. Goods worth rupees 15,000 sent by Lucknow branch to Chennai branch was in transit on 31st March 2016. And we have to prepare necessary ledger accounts under stock and data system in the books of head office. Lucknow branch stock account divided into debit and a credit side. We will check up the entries on the debit side first, then we will go to the credit side. On the debit side, it is the first entry that we are passing on 1st April 2015. Two balance brought down 30,000 rupees. Next entry is to goods sent to branch account 3,25,000 rupees, and on 31st March we have two branch debtors account, that is return inwards, which is 500 rupees. Coming to credit side, entries passed on 2016 March 31st by branch cash account. For cash sales, amount is taken as 1 lakh rupee. By branch debtors account, entry for the credit sale, amount is taken 1,75,000 rupees. By goods sent to branch account, these are returns from branch, amount is 10,000 rupees. There is a pilferage, so the entry is by pilferage account 2,000 rupees. By loss by fire account, which is a loss by fire, 5,000 rupees. By Chennai branch account, goods transferred but they are still in transit, not reached to Chennai, amount is 15,000 rupees. And finally, by balance carried down 48,400 rupees, and a total of the account on both sides 3,55,500 rupees. Next account, once again, Lucknow branch debtors account. Again, starting from debit side, April 1st, 2015, this is the opening balance that we have taken, that is 10,000 rupees. And the second entry is on 31st March 2016, to branch stock account, this is for credit sale, amount is 1,75,000 rupees. If you see the credit side, entries are passed on 31st March 2016 by branch profit and loss account, these are for the bad debts, 500 rupees. By branch stock account, this is for return inwards, which is taken as 500 rupees. And by branch cash account, which is collection from customers, and the figure which is given as 1,70,000 rupees is actually calculated as a balancing figure after writing the closing balance. Closing balance carried down is 14,000. And branch cash account are the collections from customer, which is the difference between the credit and the debit, 1,70,000 rupees. And then the total we have taken on both the sides, 1,80,000 85,000 rupees on debit and a credit side. Lucknow branch stock adjustment account. See the debit side. This is made on 31st March 2016 and entire loading is adjusted over here. Two goods sent to branch account, loading on goods return 10,000 into 1/5. So, that comes to 2,000. To branch stock account, the loading comes as 400 by, this is for pilferage loading account. Then there is loss by fire account, the loading that is taken is 1/5 of 5,000 rupees, that is taken as 1,000. Goods are sent to Chennai branch and the loading is 1/5 of 15,000 rupees, which comes to 3,000, and then to branch profit and loss account. This is the gross profit transferred, which is balancing figure actually, and the amount that is taken is 54,900 rupees. And finally, balance carried down, which is the loading on the closing stock, rupees 48,500 into 1/5, 9,700 rupees. And then if you see the credit side, all the entries are passed on 31st March 2016. By balance brought down, it is 6,000. This is the loading on the opening stock, which is taken as 1/5 of 30,000 rupees. And by goods sent to branch account, loading 3,25,000 and 1/5 of that, which comes to 65,000 rupees. So, the branch stock adjustment account is adjusting loading on opening stock, closing stock, pilferage and so on. And difference between the credit and the debit side is either the profit or the loss transferred to the general P&L account. Total of this account, we have taken 71,000 rupees on both sides. We have branch profit and loss account. Again, all the entries are passed on 31st March 2016. If you see the debit side, there are bad debts. So, it is two branch debtors account, 500 rupees, insurance 500 rupees, pilferage 1,600, stock lost by fire 1,000, petty expenses 33,820, and two general profit and loss account, which is the branch profit finally transferred to the profit and loss account. Amount that is calculated is 17,480. And how this is calculated? If you see the credit side, by branch stock adjustment account, the gross profit is 54,900. And difference between the credit side total and the debit side total is the profit 17,480. Total of the account on both sides, 54,900 rupees. We have stock reserve account. Again, the entries passed on 31st March 2016. Two stock adjustment account on the debit side for a transfer, which comes to 6,000. On the debit side, two balance carried down 9,700, which is the balance between credit and the debit side. And on the credit side, if you see, entry number 1 is made opening balance. So, it is on 1st April 2015. By balance brought down 6,000 and 31st March 2016 by branch stock adjustment account 9,700 rupees. And if you see the total on both the sides, 15,700 rupees. So, this is a stock reserve account. Then we have stock lost by fire account. And there will be entry coming on the debit side. To Lucknow branch stock account, it is 5,000. Entry made on 31st March 2015. If you see the credit side, 31st March 2016, by branch stock adjustment account 1,000 rupees, by bank for insurance claim that is 3,000 rupees, and by branch profit and loss account balancing figure of 1,000 rupees, and the total of the account comes 5,000 rupees. And finally, you will find petty cash account. Petty cash account is basically for meeting the miscellaneous type of expense, which are small in nature. 31st March 2015, if you see the debit side, balance brought down 50 rupees is actually given in the example, from there we have taken it. if you see on 31st March 2016, 2 cash 34,000, this is the cash received during the year by branch profit and loss account, that is on the credit side on 31st March 2016. These are for the expenses incurred. Expenses incurred are not actually given. That is the balancing figure 33,820, and what is given in the example is the closing balance, and the closing balance is given as 230. So, opening balance plus cash received minus closing balance is equal to the amount which is spent, and amount which is spent represents 33,820, which has been shown on the credit side of the petty cash account. And if you see the total comes 34,050 on both the sides. So, this is petty cash account that we have opened. So, friends, to draw the conclusion, we have seen both the methods of keeping accounts in case of branch transactions. We are sure that you must have understood the difference between debtor system and stock and debtor system very well. Thank you very much.